Hello there, Callum Johns here, back with more LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. Yes, so I'm going to jump into the super story and the, well, basically the bonuses for the whole episode of Episode 4, A New Hope. Episode 4 bonus. I'm thinking I'll start with these smaller bonuses first, and then I'll do the super story at the end. Does it say something different, or does it say the same thing? I might have been missing... Oh, it does say something different. I might have been missing reading out things. Anyway, character bonus. Mos Eisley. While the Rebel Alliance struggles heroically with the oppressive Empire, and as Luke Skywalker moves closer to his epic destiny, daily life goes on across the galaxy. In the sprawling alleyways of Mos Eisley, intrepid adventurers compete to collect 1 million LEGO studs in the fastest time possible. It's a desperate, ruthless life of a world in turmoil. Yep, I skipped the thing before that would have told me what I actually needed to do. Great. Oh well, that's the basic premise of these, I guess, so... No harm then. Oh, okay, that worked. That's cool. I've already got over 850,000. Which is also over 9,000! Of course, all the memes. But that's cool. What can I do here? Boom, 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 boom. No, well, there's a million. That was quick. I seem to have gotten the hang of these now fairly well. So that's cool. No, there's only 5 more gold bricks to go. Mos Eisley Cantina. Cool. Now on to the mini kit bonus. What shall I pick for this one? Let's do a mini Star Destroyer. Why not? I'm not going to worry about the crawl for this. Yeah, the Star Destroyer is actually quite slow. Oh, that's much quicker, much better maneuverability. Oh, I didn't realize the Star Destroyers were so slow in the miniature form when the rest weren't. So we're actually starting from the end, I think. Oh, one of them. They're different areas anyway, I think. So that's cool. Oh, there's another thing for the Sith Infiltrator. I do like. It's actually, I think it'd have to be my favourite ship from the movies. It's Sith Infiltrator here. You know, Darth Maul's ship. Just because of its cool design. The Millennium Falcon would be a favourite, not just because of design, because of its plot relevance. But I think, as far as just design goes, the Sith Infiltrator is the... What is this doing there? Right. It would be my favourite just for design. There should be a proton torpedo thing somewhere. The question is where. Oh, they've got a few of these sorts of ones. That's different. But they can do that because it's the Death Star. That's cool. So just having towers, they have the other bits and pieces. Alright, now we're in business. There we go, the million. Not too hard once you get the hang of it. And know what you actually want to do. I'm not going to worry about the crawls too much for those, because I already skipped through a bunch of them. I don't know why I did, but they'll be the similar sort of premise as the others. And so next will be the super story. Super story. And those would be the same sort of thing. They probably just have the crawl from the movie, to be honest. I got the awesome scene right here. Oh, I love this scene in the movie as well, just that opening shot. I wouldn't change it for anything. Also shows it has two moons for Tatooine to go with the two suns, which is interesting there. I forget if it has any more moons, but it has two there. So it's cool. And the first character to speak in Star Wars is C-3PO. So here we are, back at this again. Get a few of these, I'll just sort of do studs as I go. Cool. All right. Alright. I can pick up most of them under there. Cool. That's handy. Boom. Oh, I used to get so annoyed. I had to jump down and get those studs and then come back up. Completionist is going, but It'll save time. Let's go. So yeah, cool. Whatever else I'm saying, yeah. I'm just sort of concentrating on doing this. So, not much other things I'm thinking of to say at the moment, but that's alright. We can see me doing super sorry. Oh, all those R2-D2 rubbish bins. What's that, where they were inspired by? So no Leia now. Shows the other perspective. And they don't leave if they're playing co-op. They don't leave the other person without a plan for too long, without someone that can shoot. Yeah, so that's nice. I'm not wasting any time, I don't feel like now, which is good. The random beach trooper. I always thought they were funny to have a beach trooper and stuff. Haha! He evaded just by building. Okay, so it's that left one lever that did it. Or it's both together. One of them. No, I have to go up here with him. Cool. They used a minifigure of the Star Destroyer there instead of the bigger one, at least for that scene. The bottom of it wasn't as detailed for the Lego model. They don't really have an argument here, comparatively. Or, well, they sort of do. Kicks him, but... They play the scenes in a different order, noticing that. They shoot R2's capture first, and then... C-3PO waves for the Sandcrawler. At least in the movie. From memory. Very cool. This is a nice experience anyway to watch the cutscenes through. And see all of the good LEGO creativity here without voices and all that. Good job to the guys at TT Games. Voices can do their thing, it opens up more possibilities, but you also don't have to be as creative when you're making a game if you've got voices. Yeah. Yeah, it's different to all of them, because in the movie it's a crate dragon roar. Alright. I'll be able to get some more studs here, that'll be good. I'll make sure to focus on getting a few more possibly. I don't need to build that, what am I doing? You can see, even with playing Ben here, the blue lightsaber against the Tatooine background isn't as good as the green lightsaber, which is where George Lucas changed Luke's lightsaber in Return of the Jedi. To be able to see it properly. Can you actually, this will be a good amount of studs here. Not much effort, so it's good. Oh, work out where you're gonna be, Luke. Can you use the force on what I want you to use it on, please? So, R2 was that one, okay. We're trying to deactivate R2, you die. Come on. That's why the Jawas are annoying. You'd be odd trying to walk up a slight slope. I know, I'm saying that a bit. Alright. Yeah, I slaughter them all like animals. It seems unlikely that Imperial forces would be so close to Ben Kenobi's hut. But oh well. They mixed together some of the different pieces of music there. I'm feeling warm now. Temperature's a little bit all over the shop. Don't worry, nobody's ever really gone. We're losing R2. course. He must have super speed on that astromech. Not gonna let us. They're not the droids you're looking for. Alrighty. Even more to go on. Yeah, I find it really cool how C-3PO's just character loses arms and a leg when it's damaged. Oh well, let's just go through. Cool, and then this is us building the ATSC, the all-terrain scout transport. Keep saying alright, stop it. I'm gonna not say alright just to fill the silence. Okay. A New Hope. The movie that changed the way cinematography goes today. Oh, it doesn't speed up 3PO. Oh well. Oh, that's nice, speedy building. I forgot the power up did that for a moment. I believe the AT-STs first appeared in Empire Strikes Back, alongside the AT-ATs. Turn around, I'm supposed to do that. Why did it throw me out of it? Okay. Can go through now. That was a little bit tenser than I thought. Yeah, if you don't serve their kind here, why do you let them in at all? Use the force field to stop them. Tom was the only one who shot. Damn. They didn't even have Dr. Cornelius Everzahn coming up alongside him. Bit different. And Dr. Everzahn's story finishes in Galaxy of Fear. The Army of the Dead, I think, is the book title. And now we have this. So they play Cantina Band number 1 for the cutscene, but this is Cantina Band number 2 now. And now we're outside, so. I'll just go through the normal way. Let's kill everything. I think I have to go up there. I do. That was a mistake on my part, I forgot. Alright, time to spam the button to shoot. Whoa, we're halfway there. Whoa, living on a prayer. Ready or not, we'll make it, I swear. We're gonna do it. So yeah, I think the original trilogy levels do go for longer than the prequel trilogy ones. Well, the reason I'm doing story mode after is I thought after this I'll probably feel like finishing the episode. Oh, and I was noticing in the classic Marvel Star Wars it isn't a cube as spy, so they hadn't actually figured out the look for the Imperial spy as a cube as, or even the cube that existed at that point. Thinking of this. Yep, they're dead now. Giving him a noogie, yeah. Or helping with the hay, one of them. Cool. No, like a spoiled princess. Thank you. Alrighty. Pretty much watching the whole movie again. I don't know why it's got some sort of aura around it. I guess that's lighting is coming off of it. Totally believable, right? Looks like he's questioning that until they show Obi-Wan. They don't even bother with the helmets. Okay, then. Let's proceed. I like how it does a little flick out of his cape. Yeah, I pretty much said everything in there. Other times. Let's go, R2. Oh yeah, you gotta have that poster shot. I'm just gonna nick off now. Bye. Han's better. I'll just keep going up here. Oh, I can't go that way, duh. Alrighty. I also like how they show off the bits and pieces with Ben doing the stuff in the background here. It's good. Come on, Ben. I can't go across until... Oh, there we go. Yeah, I like how they show that side by side there. It's not accurate to the plans of the Death Star, but it looks cool. Open the blast door, yeah. Just gotta go this way then. Alright, need a stormtrooper helmet. Alright. Looks like a stormtrooper now, right? Oh, and a bit of the head under the helmet. Okay, do okay. I just ran through that, that's fun. Of course, another one of these. I didn't keep the stormtrooper helmet. That's just what sets me back a bit sometimes. Just here. Come on, you're in the way, fool. Pretty sure it's this one I need to go up, down, take it all around. Cool. And it's this one. Cool. Yeah, there we go. Cutscene triggered a bit off, then took its time. And then the next one. Woo! Woo! So it'd be a nice slot. It'd be cool if they actually did a ride, a Star Wars ride where you went along and did some things like that. Just not the smell with it. There we go. Handy little R2. Oh, you silly. I'm gonna just helmet everyone so that we might have one by the end of the day when we need it. Yeah, that's right, Chewie. From memory, there's a... Cool. Easy. So they all lost their helmets, but I didn't. Why did I even bother? You're the pilot, huh? You can drive this car as well, then. Forgot things are in the way. course, it was a bit slow because I didn't get the run up. Come on, you silly thing. I did that in time. There we go. Jumping from a face plant, definitely something that certain people can do. If they don't attack me, I can just walk through. Why not? Oh, now they attack me. They can see me fixing their mistakes. It's actually nice that this series will go a bit longer than I thought it would. It's been a long ride, but it's been good. And it's fun. Despite some of the annoying things in it. I have to get the helm, of course. Just after I got it. Go away. This is painful. Don't you dare. Thank you. Alright, should be able to make it this one. I opened it, that's enough. Alrighty. I did it again, I said alright. Oh, I don't need that. Alright, that should work. Come on, build it. Yes. Go, go, go. Alright. I just need all the bits and pieces from here. There we are. Alright, just do all of the astromech things. I've got my 100,000. I wasn't really focused on getting studs, and I was thinking in the last level I could grab a decent amount. I was trying to do the run on it. Okay, has it calmed down so I can actually do things? Oh, it seems to have. Okay. That's one of them. I need 3PO. Of course, there's so many. Why does 3PO have to be the furthest away? Anyway, getting there, and 'tis good. Now where does he go? I can fall off the edge here, I guess. Come on. Can you go? Oh, I have to kill enough dudes to be able to leave. I went out for all of them, but the original trilogy levels go for take longer to complete, so it's a bit odd. They should have changed the time depending on how long the levels take to complete. And then next should just be the rebel attack level. Shouldn't take too long to just blast through that. Let's go. Into the Death Star. Boom. Of course, this music will probably get copyrighted, so if ads come up, it is not I. I'm too small to get a monetization anyway for my channel. Since they changed the rules to needing 1,000 subscribers and 4K watch hours. Nice. Power up. Yeah, I got plenty of studs from this level. I would have made 100,000 easy. I really like the X-Wings as well as far as starships. They're cool. And I like how they're shown to be not as polished. How they're a bit more gritty and not as advanced as the TIE fighters. It shows the technological superiority of the Empire. It also goes to show that it's not what you have, it's how you use it. And even if you have a huge super weapon, if you've got a top fighter, you can still cause a lot of damage depending on how you use it. So this will be the final trench run. Ah, it's got the cutscene here. Nice. Cool. I've got three somehow, okay. Zigzag, they can't hit you as much when you zigzag. So cool. It'd be interesting if you destroyed the support ships first. Because you can do that. I did it in free play mode, I think. I feel like they just lifted the Yeehaw from the clip. From the movie. Because I had a different sort of sound to it. Of course, all of the actual voices I put in these early games are weird. Like the one on Anakin's flight. Oh, that was hilarious. They restarted the music, they could have kept it going possibly, but they have to have the certain audio with the cutscene, I guess. Which is cool. Nice. We'll get all of the cutscenes probably. Yep. There we go. They have the Cubas spy there, which is interesting. As far as the spy and the rebellion at that point, could that be referencing possibly a tiny bit later when Rebel Force? Maybe. Yeah, my scores and stuff. It's possible. I don't need the credit for this one. 97.7%. Getting even closer. That will be all for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. Hope you've enjoyed it. And I'll see you in the next episode. Or the next video, depending on which video you watch next.